हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पार्ट 5 ऑफ द वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 14, सब्सटेंसेस इन कॉमन यूज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9th। चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दैट द न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट्स इज अनस्टेबल, सो सच न्यूक्लियाई एमिट रेडिएशंस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी। Here you can see energy is released and also particles, and this is done in order to make the nuclei more stable. So the process of emission of energy and particles from the nuclei of radioactive elements to make it more stable is called as radioactive decay. So here you can see this is the nucleus of uranium. When this uranium nucleus undergoes radioactive decay, it is releasing some particles along with energy. So definition of radioactive decay is when the nuclei of radioactive elements emit radiations in the form of energy and particles to become more stable, then the phenomenon is called as radioactive decay. Children, we have already studied in the last part of the video that radioactive radiations are of three major types: alpha radiations, beta radiations, and gamma radiations. Alpha radiations and beta radiations are one or more particles that are released from the nuclei of radioactive substances, whereas gamma radiations are not particles, these are high energy electromagnetic radiations. So now we will be studying the properties of alpha rays, beta rays, and gamma rays in detail. So we'll begin with the properties of alpha particles or alpha rays or alpha radiations. Now, when does the nuclei of a radioactive element emit alpha particles? When the nucleus is unstable because of too many protons, then the radioactive decay takes place by releasing the alpha particles along with energy. So here you can see that there is a nuclei of uranium and it is emitting the alpha particles in order to become more stable. And what does this uranium nucleus release? It releases two protons and two neutrons. So when alpha decay of any radioactive substance takes place, then two protons and two neutrons are emitted from the nucleus of that radioactive element. Now you will find that the alpha particles are represented as the nucleus of helium. That is, you will find that it is represented as helium with atomic number 2 and atomic mass number 4. So why is this so? Because the alpha particles are same as the nucleus of helium. So that is the reason why alpha particles are represented as He with atomic number 2 and atomic mass number 4. Helium particles, alpha particles, do not have electrons revolving around the nucleus, because alpha particles contain only two protons and two neutrons. They do not contain electrons. So you will find that alpha particles are a current of positively charged particles. Why positively charged particles? Because the alpha particles release two protons and two neutrons. What is the charge carried by protons? Positive charge. What is the charge carried by neutrons? No charge. So in this case, suppose if I say that the uranium nucleus releases two protons and two neutrons, so plus 2, and the charge carried by neutrons is neutral. Therefore, the charge on the nucleus becomes positive because of the presence of positively charged protons. So alpha particles are a current of positively charged particles. What do they release? They release two protons and two neutrons. How are the alpha particles denoted or referred to as? They are referred to as helium nucleus. And how are the alpha particles represented? They are represented as the nucleus of helium with atomic number 2 and atomic mass number 4. Or they are also shown as current of helium particles. So they are written as helium with 2 positive charges on them. The mass of alpha particles is 4 times more than the mass of a proton. So the mass of alpha particles is 4.0028 Daltons. Charge on alpha particles is 2 times more than the charge on a proton. So the charge on alpha particles is denoted as plus 2. Velocity of alpha particles is less than the velocity of light. It is 1/5 to 1/20th times to that of the velocity of light. Now, when the alpha particles are passed in an electric field, so here you can see a positively charged plate and a negatively charged plate, and an electric field is set up. So the radiations which are coming out from the radioactive substance is made to pass through this electric field. So what do we find? That when alpha particles are passed through an electric field, then the alpha particles get deflected towards the negatively charged plate. Penetration power of alpha particles is very low. So here you can see the alpha particles cannot even penetrate a sheet of paper. Alpha particles strongly ionizes the gas through which it passes. Now, what is meant by ionization? Whenever a neutral atom converts into a positive ion or a negative ion, then it is called as ionization. Now, what happens when alpha particles passes through any medium? When alpha particle passes through a medium, for example, gases, then it influences the electrons which are present in the gaseous medium, and thereby the atoms of gas becomes positively charged. What is the alpha particles doing? The alpha particles ionizes the gases by strongly attracting the electrons from a distance. So alpha particles have a very high ionization power, especially when it passes through the gases. So alpha particles strongly ionizes the gases through which it pass. Alpha particles have the power to produce fluorescence. Now, fluorescence is the emission of light by certain substances that have absorbed light or other electromagnetic radiations. For example, you must have seen that the radium stickers glow in the dark, isn't it? So that is the property of fluorescence, which is shown by the radium stickers. Beta particles are fast moving electrons which are ejected from the nucleus of a radioactive substance. The beta particles are represented as an electron with atomic number minus 1 and atomic mass number 0. So beta particles are fast moving electrons. How are they represented? E minus 1, 0. The mass of beta particles is 0.000548 Daltons. The charge on the beta particles is minus 1. Velocity of beta particles is again less than the velocity of light. It is 1/5 to 9/10 times the velocity of light. When beta particles pass through an electric field, you will find that the beta particles, they get attracted towards the positively charged plate, because beta particles are the fast moving electrons. So they get attracted towards the positively charged plate. Penetration power of beta particles is more than the penetration power of alpha particles, because here you can see the beta particles can pass through the sheet of aluminium. So penetration power of beta particles is more than the penetration power of the alpha particles. Ionization power of the beta particles is low. It is 1/100 time of that of the alpha particles. beta particles can influence the particles only when they are very close to the particles. So the atoms can become positively charged only when the beta particles are close to the atom. Thereby, the beta particles will attract the electrons towards itself, making the gaseous atoms positively charged. So ionizing power of beta particles is low as compared to that of alpha particles. Power to produce fluorescence in case of beta particles is low as compared to alpha particles. Let us see the properties of gamma rays or gamma radiations. Now, sometimes the nucleus remains in a very excited state. So, in order to attain a low energy state, which is much more stable, the nucleus emits gamma rays. So, gamma rays are radiations and not particles like the alpha particles and the beta particles. Gamma rays are the most energetic form of electromagnetic radiations. Gamma rays have no mass. These are electrically neutral radiations. Velocity of gamma rays is same as the velocity of light. And what is the velocity of light? 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. So gamma rays travel at the speed of light. We have already seen that the gamma rays do not get deflected in an electric field. Penetration power of gamma rays is very high as compared to the alpha radiations and the beta radiations, because gamma rays can penetrate a 15 centimeter thick lead block. So penetration power of gamma rays is 10,000 times more than that of the alpha particles. Ionization power of gamma rays is very low because gamma rays have no charge. Therefore, they cannot influence the nucleus. The power to produce fluorescence is very low in case of gamma rays as compared to alpha rays and beta rays. So children, to sum up the properties of alpha, beta and gamma rays, you can see that the properties are put in a tabular form. You can be asked to write down the properties of alpha rays, properties of beta rays or properties of gamma rays. Or it could be distinguished between alpha rays and beta rays and gamma rays, or alpha rays and gamma rays. So, alpha rays are current of alpha particles or current of helium nuclei. Beta rays are current of beta particles, that is negatively charged electrons. And gamma rays are electromagnetic radiations. Mass of alpha particles is 4.0028 Daltons. Mass of beta particles is 0.00548 Daltons. And gamma rays have no mass. Charge carried by alpha particle is plus 2. Charge carried by beta particles is minus 1. And gamma rays are electrically neutral. Velocity or speed of the alpha particles is 1/5 to 120 times the velocity of light. Velocity of beta particles is 1/5 to 9/10 times the velocity of light. Gamma rays have same velocity as that of light. In an electric field, the alpha rays are deviated towards the negatively charged plate. The beta rays are attracted towards a positively charged plate, and gamma rays do not get deviated in an electric field. Alpha rays have a very low penetration power. Beta rays have a high penetration power. Gamma rays have a very high penetration power. Ionization power of alpha rays is very high. Beta rays have a low ionization power, whereas gamma rays have a very low ionization power. Alpha rays have high power to produce fluorescence. Beta rays have very low power to produce fluorescence. And gamma rays have low power to produce fluorescence.